Glay is my go-to descendant when I want to hold left click and blast the target until it falls down without caring about ammo consumption. Glay has a skill called Frenzied, which increases firearm and explosive attack by +15%. It also increases firearm penetration by 51 and increases received damage by 10%, meaning you take 10% more damage. Using Frenzied and increased sensory maximized lethality makes ammo cost per shot 0, making it infinite ammo for a certain duration. The drawback is that Glay's running speed, sprint speed, and movement speed when aiming is reduced by -50%, which is not a big deal since you can still grapple and roll. For the build, let's start with the reactor. For the reactor, you can use any reactor as long as you have skill cooldown and skill duration up. For the external components, let's start with the auxiliary power, prioritize 2 HP option, and module drop rate increase modifier. If you are fighting a fire type colossus, then go for 2 HP and fire resistance. For the sensor, prioritize defense and consumable drop rate increase modifier. For the last option, you can pick whatever you want. If you're trying to level up a descendant, then go for a character XP gain modifier. If you are fighting a chill type colossus, then go for chill resistance. For the memory, prioritize 2 defense and then pick whatever option depending on what you are doing. If you are leveling a weapon, then go for firearm proficiency gain modifier. If you are farming gold, then go for gold drop rate increase modifier. And if you are fighting an electric colossus, then go for electric resistance. For the processor, prioritize defense and equipment drop rate increase modifier. For the last option, you can go for item acquisition distance increase modifier, or if you are fighting a toxic type colossus, then go for toxin resistance. If you are wondering why I'm not using a set external components, that is because these sets are so hard to find and getting the best stats is not that easy. Now, some of you might get lucky, but in my case, I just can't get the right stats on each components. The most important thing is getting the right stats for each components, and for me personally, the set bonus is really not that great, and it is not that game-changing. For the modules, let's start with the sub-module. Always go for mid-air maneuvering. This sub-module is the best sub-module since you can grapple wherever you want and reposition quickly. For the HP, go for Steam Accelerant and increased HP, increasing max HP by 452%. For the defense module, go for Shield Conversion and increased defense, increasing defense by 327%. This build is all about improving the duration and the cooldown of increased sensory. Go for maximized duration and skill extension, increasing skill duration by 76%. These two modules will increase the duration of increased sensory from 5 seconds to 9 seconds. To lower the cooldown, go for MP conversion and nimble fingers, lowering the cooldown by 62%. This lowers the cooldown from 40 seconds to 12 seconds. This will extend the usage of a single magazine, making it incredibly efficient. To gain back lost HP, go for HP Collector, which instantly recovers 9% of max HP with a 2-second cooldown. You can also replace HP Collector with a level 1 antifreeze solution, perfect anti-venom, heat release, and insulated conductor depending on the type of colossus that you are fighting. Antifreeze solution is incredibly good against Frostwalker and Gluttony. The main reason why I always use this module is simply because these modules reduces the damage over time you take and make you invulnerable from getting frozen in place. For the last socket, you have a couple of choices. If you are doing invasion mission, infiltration operations, or any regular missions, you can go for shot focus, which increases firearm attack by 15%. The only downside with shot focus is that you can only obtain this module through combining modules. If you are going to do Void Intercept Battle or Colossus boss fight, then go for auto immunity, which decreases incoming damage by -10%. Lastly, for the skill modules, you have two choices, Predator Instinct and Super Senses. If you are using a machine gun or a submachine gun, then go for Predator Instinct. This transcendent module will increase firearm attack by 21% at level 2 as long as you are holding the fire button for more than 2 seconds. If you are using a sniper rifle or a launcher, then go for Super Senses. This transcendent module will increase the duration of maximized lethality from 8 seconds to 15 seconds, which will make your sniper rifle or launcher have infinite ammo every time you use your Super Senses. These transcendent modules are not mandatory and are pretty expensive, so you have an option not to use these transcendent modules. Using increased sensory takes a little bit of time getting used to it. There are times where you simply forget to use the skill because you are so focused on something else, so a little bit of practice is needed. If you are looking for a machine gun, submachine gun, and sniper rifle build, there is a link down below. Overall, this build has a total of 85k defense and 16k HP. This is more than enough to successfully beat any type of content in the game. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.